always taking action for you.
First at 11, the countdown clock is ticking with the poll set to open in less than 8 hours as you get the final say in Democracy 2014.
Here in Michigan, the tightest race statewide is, of course, at the top of the ticket.
Yeah, just 2 points separating the candidates for governor in our exclusive poll just last week.
Tonight, we have Team 7 coverage of their final push.
We're going to begin with 7 Action News reporter Tara Edwards and Governor Snyder's campaign live tonight in Livonia. Tara?
Well, Stephen and Carolyn, it's been a very busy week for the governor, and he expects the next 24 hours to be busy as well, as he will be voting, spending time with family and supporters.
Supporters getting fired up at the Republican Livonia field office.
We need to accelerate what we've been doing.
Flanked by Republican candidates, Governor Rick Snyder stopped in western Wayne County as part of a 3-day bus tour to rally voters.
People are fired up around Michigan to continue the reinvention of our state. We've created nearly 300,000 private sector jobs, number 5 in the country.
Lately, the governor has been in a tight race with challenger Mark Schauer, enduring some criticism of his administration's spending on education in the state.
I'm glad to get my record clear that I've increased education spending. 10.6 before I took office in terms of billion, 11.7 the budget I just signed. And
Snyder is asking Detroiters to look at his achievements over the past 4 years.
Well, hopefully they look at the candidate and not just look at it as a partisan issue, because I'm really proud of the track record.
And Governor Snyder says that he hopes that Detroiters look at what's been done in the city over the past 4 years. He says that more has been done over the past 4 years than in the past decade or so. Live in Livonia, Tara Edwards, 7 Action News.
All right, thanks a lot, Tara.
All right, let's turn now to 7 Action News reporter Jeff Vaughn and the final night of the campaign for the Democratic challenger, Mark Schauer. Jeff.
Yeah, Stephen, we caught up with Schauer here at this Plymouth coffee shop where he was making an appeal to those undecided voters.
How are you?
Mark Schauer stepping off his campaign RV in Plymouth, where he talked to undecided voters assembled at a Plymouth coffee shop.
I'm going to talk to as many voters as I can until 8 o'clock tomorrow night.
Schauer, who's in a tight race with incumbent Republican Governor Rick Snyder, believes he has made up the margin in absentee ballots.
We know early votes have been very high, and I have a double-digit lead among early votes. I think people are ready for change.
Schauer leaving Plymouth for Ann Arbor, where he will talk with college Democrats at U of M, then off to his hometown of Battle Creek, where he's going to greet cereal workers at the Kellogg plant just as the polls open election day.
Just turning out our base. You know, at this point, it's a jump ball election, and every vote matters.
Let me give you a list now of local politicians, beginning with Mayor Mike Duggan, Senator Debbie Stabenow, Senator Carl Levin, Representatives Sandra Levin and John Conyers, none of which actively campaigned for Schauer. But President Obama did, Michelle Obama as well, as did Hillary Clinton, which means the White House thinks that Schauer can win. Live in Plymouth tonight, I'm Jeff Vaughn, 7 Action News.
One thing's for sure, every vote will count tomorrow.
We're so close on this one, Jeff, thanks.